Today, the New York City mayor is answering the question that a bunch of people are asking, which is, why are we getting warned about how to stay safe from a nuclear attack right now? Like, what? That's after this new PSA started airing, explaining how to do just that. Keep yourself safe from nukes, with Mayor Eric Adams saying, hey, don't freak out. No need to panic, but be prepared. The odds of a nuclear attack, pretty low. But city officials at the Office of Emergency Management want to make sure you know what to do to stay safe if it ever came to that. Pretty basic stuff. Go inside and stay there. But people are wondering what is up with the timing of this message.
But no need to evacuate just yet. In a statement, the New York City Department of Emergency Management saying that, quote, the likelihood of a nuclear weapon incident occurring in or near New York City is very low.
There's no specific threat. We've received feedback that, not surprisingly, this scenario is something that people don't feel prepared for, and they ask us for advice. So, you know, this was an effort to provide some straightforward advice around a difficult topic.
Mayor Eric Adams adding that the move comes amid rising tensions in Ukraine.
I'm a big believer in better safe than sorry. I take my hat off to OEM. This was right after the attacks in the Ukraine.
Is a nuclear attack something you think about at all? Is that on your mind?
I don't think about it that much just because it seems so far-fetched.
Although the PSA targeted New Yorkers, it's a message some experts think could resonate with the nation overall.
My sense is better education would be helpful. Just knowing some basic things like, again, stay inside.
And no, staying in the car is not an option. You need to get into a building and move away from the windows.
Do you feel prepared for a nuclear attack?
No. Not by a long shot.
I don't know what I would do. Maybe that doesn't sound very intelligent, but I really don't know what I would do.
They manage the doomsday clock, designed to warn the world about man-made threats like nuclear war, amongst other issues. Recently, they set the clock for 100 seconds to midnight, saying in part, quote, Russia's invasion of Ukraine has brought this nightmare scenario to life, with Russian President Vladimir Putin threatening to elevate nuclear alert levels and even first use of nuclear weapons if NATO steps in to help Ukraine. This is what 100 seconds to midnight looks like.
A nuclear attack is unfortunately a real part of our world, and I think the risk will only grow over time. Having said that, I don't think that people should allow concern about nuclear attack to dominate their everyday lives.
Biden just took another $1.3 billion of our money to send to Ukraine. On Friday, he took $800 million to send to Ukraine to keep bloodying the killing fields. The grand total now, since that cover was printed, almost $60 billion as our fucking infrastructure is rotting and the country's going down. Remember what I said. They're not going to call this a war. Again, we're not at a proxy war. We're at war. If I asked you to give me something to go kill somebody and you gave it to me and I killed somebody, you're an accessory to the crime. The $60 billion and bloodying the killing fields, we're at war with Russia. And again, it's all in your Trends Journal, all the details. Putin's saying you haven't seen anything yet. They could blow over this place in a jiffy if they wanted. Look at this video clip that they're publishing in New York City that went out yesterday.
So there's been a nuclear attack. Don't ask me how or why, just know that the big one has hit, okay? So what do we do? There are three important steps that I want you to remember. Step one, get inside fast. You, your friends, your family, get inside. And no, staying in the car is not an option. You need to get into a building and move away from the windows. Step two, stay inside. Shut all doors and windows. Have a basement? Head there. If you don't have one, get as far into the middle of the building as possible. If you were outside after the blast, get clean immediately. Remove and bag all outer clothing to keep radioactive dust or ash away from your body. Step three, stay tuned. Follow media for more information. Don't forget to sign up for Notify NYC for official alerts and updates. and don't go outside until officials say it's safe. All right, you've got this.
Can you believe this shit? Can you believe this shit? This clown going out there? Oh, she's so calm. Oh, and the picture of, right out of Sesame Street. If a goddamn nuclear bomb fell, the fucking place would be destroyed. Nobody out on the streets. Oh, there she is, nice and calm. And I'm telling you what to do. I'll tell you what to do. You know who I am? I'm some piece of shit that I'm an actress, you know, dressed up in perfectly black and maybe even a woke gender. Because she knows how to throw out that shit so calmly and so nicely and giving you all this fucking bullshit that'll have nothing to do to save your life. Oh, and don't go out until the officials tell you. Oh, the officials. The official shitheads. The official scumbags. The official pricks. And I can't say the other word. Can you imagine this? This is where we're going. They are leading us to World War III.
So they've introduced a nuclear preparedness public service announcement video. And this video, I'm going to go through it and we're going to break it down. How absolutely bizarre and poorly made this video really is. And before anyone says or thinks this is a joke video, no, look, this is the source of it. It's legitimately from the NYC Emergency Management. Here is their YouTube channel, and here is the video that we're going to go through right now.
So there's been a nuclear attack. Don't ask me how or why. Just know that the big one has hit, okay? So what do we do?
Okay, I mean, where do we even start with this? Right, A, the CGI graphics are absolutely terrible. The lady does not look as though she is anything to do with emergency responses. B, C, she said, okay, so. I mean, I wouldn't even start an emergency message like that. There's been a nuclear attack. No big deal. Don't ask me how or why. Why? Why don't you know why there's been a... I mean, it is so bizarre. But let me answer the question. If you lived in New York City and there was a nuclear attack, what would you do? Well, you would most likely be dead. But it looks like she's going to give some good advice now, some amazing advice. This is 2022 after all. I'm sure she's going to tell us now exactly what we should do specifically.
There are three important steps that I want you to remember. Step one, get inside fast. And no, staying in the car is not an option.
Okay, I mean, you see how crazy this video is. So there's been a nuclear blast. Number one, you'd be dead anyway. Let's just get that out of the way. But what do? Get inside. And then she said, don't get into your car. Who, honestly, who would get into a car if there was either a nuclear blast about to happen or a nuclear blast has already gone off? Or the window, the whole car would have been flown out anyway, if not just absolutely the glass destroyed and everything else. I don't really understand who this video is aimed at. If you want to know what would happen to a house, I've actually got some genuine footage to show you here, so have a look at it.
Step two, stay inside. Shut all doors and windows.
Yeah, great idea. Get inside, close your windows. Here we go, here's an example of that. Hi honey, I'm home for my cup of tea. Oh!
If you don't have one, get as far into the middle of the building as possible.
Yeah, get into the middle of a building. Definitely great advice there, because when the building explodes and everything just, you know, collapses around you and all the debris, you're going to get crushed in the middle. Great. So let me just show you a really, really great video that I found, which actually illustrates what would actually happen.
But the very structures that offered this protection would then become a cause of injury, as debris would rip through buildings and rain down on city streets.
If you were outside after the blast, get clean immediately. Step three, stay tuned. Follow media for more information. Don't forget to sign up for Notify NYC for official alerts and updates.
Oh yeah, listen to the media. They have got your best interests at heart. I mean, they've done great so far, haven't they? To be honest, I wouldn't be surprised if they announced the day before, oh, tomorrow is National Picnic Day. Everyone get to Central Park or something like that. And besides, I don't think they've thought this through logically. If you had a blast like that, how could you stay tuned to the media? There would be no electricity or any, I mean, there'd be no form of communication. And I doubt many people have got a wind-up radio. Maybe 0.1% of all New Yorkers, perhaps.
And don't go outside until officials say it's safe. All right, you've got this.
Wow, you've got this. No, you probably haven't, New York. I'm pretty sure 99.9% of people in the affected areas here would not actually survive, in all honesty. Let's just put that out there. And even that last point about staying inside until it's safe to do so, even these 1950s videos went into great detail. Stay inside for about 4 days. Why? Because of all the fallout, that, you know, the particles and things, eventually they'll get blown away by the wind and everything else. I mean, how difficult is it to say that to people? Because you know yourself, if you don't explain the reason why to people in this day and age, they just won't do it. The other thing I was surprised by was that she didn't mention food. You know, make sure you've got some supplies of food, make sure you've got supplies of water, because no electricity, no water, you're not going to have lights, you're not going to, I mean, it was just really baffling to me, this whole video, to be honest. If you had perhaps 50% of the city wiped out by a blast like this, and remember, you're not going to get the sort of warnings that they used to get in, you know, the 1940s, you're not going to get those same warnings anymore. Why? Because they now, all of these sort of missiles are hypersonic missiles. They're not, I can't remember what they used to be called, but now they're hypersonic. So before they used to go up like this, but now they can just, you know, go at really, really fast speeds at very low altitudes, i.e. getting to the target a lot quicker. So in all honesty, I think the majority of people, if there was a nuclear attack on a major city, the majority of people wouldn't survive.
Upon detonation, a fireball as hot as the sun would expand to a radius of 800 meters. Those near the blast would be vaporized.
I mean, everything I'm hearing so far from all of these videos and the research I'm doing is, if you want to survive, don't live in the center of a big city. Don't live within the first 11, 12 kilometers of the center of that big city. And best case scenario, get away from these densely populated areas, these big cities. It is just, you are asking for trouble.
I'm Nicole Kidman, and I am going to eat a four-course meal of bugs. I am here to reveal my hidden talent, eating micro livestock, cornworms. They're still alive. Extraordinary. Very moist, chewy. Can't quite describe the flavor, but need a little water. Let's try the second course, shall we? Just a little side note. 2 billion people in the world eat bugs, and I'm one of them. Because here we go. Have some mealworms. I'm telling you, I'd win Survivor. That is a fruity taste. I'd recommend it. Here we have. Oh, crickets. Oh, nothing. Oh, awesome. Like nothing you've ever tasted. Like a hairy nut. Don't. Oh my gosh. A nut from the shell.
Nasty bitch.
And now for dessert. The fried grasshopper. These are amazing. These are exquisite grasshoppers. I recommend them to anyone. Thank you for spending so much time with me and watching me eat bugs. Till next time.
You see the hard part where you have the teeth?
Oh, wow.
Take the fangs out.
Yeah. Have you done this before?
Yeah. I think it's always been a part of the diet, the bugs. Now, but then I think there is a truth to the survival during the war. Yes. Of course, people, when people were being starved, they were able to
survive
on things like this, and they did.
When was the first time you had these bugs?
I first had them when I was first in country. Crickets. You start with crickets.
Yeah.
Crickets in a beer, and then you kind of, you know, move up to tarantulas. Go ahead. How do you flip a scorpion? Good? Is that good, guys? Dinner. You want to go? Want to share a spider? Hot? It's actually really good, the flavor. Okay.
Mmm, it's nice. Huh? I can see why you're into this.
It's hard to chew, the scorpion.
Dry chips.
Like chips, yeah. Some chips
and some. Yeah, like flavorless chips.
Yeah. Many surprises.
Let's start with these guys. These are grasshopper kebabs. Okay. Teriyaki marinated, quite delicious. I heartily encourage that you try one.
Okay. Anna, do you want to try it? You want to try one?
I am trying for everyone.
Try? You try?
Yes, no, yes.
You don't have to. You don't have to. All right, ready? Nice. Cheers. Nice. You win.
I do already.
You know, I wouldn't serve it if it wasn't good. That's my motto.
What's that now? Yeah.
So, you know, also right here, if you have kids, you're always serving them ants on a log with raisins.
Uh-huh.
Come on, really. These are ants on a log with ants.
So these are actual ants.
These are black ants from China. And, you know, in China, they say that ants are medicinal. They sell them as medicine. And if you eat them, it slows the aging process and increases sexual vigor.
Ooh. It increases sexual vigor.
Oh, all right, you're gonna pass. I never force food on anyone.
I like to eat, but damn.
Is there anything you won't try?
You know, growing up as a kid, I hated calf's liver, and I still hate it. That's where I draw the line. Anything else? I'm fine.
What have we got? What have we got here? What
is? Moving right along here. These are cockroach canapes. Yeah, I knew I'd get a reaction out of you that way. And these are on goat cheese, of course, and on the. We want to go all the way here.
I know. You up for a cockroach? This is weird. I know I don't like goat's cheese. So is it weird to just go with a
cockroach? Oh, yeah, just go for the cockroach.
It's all right. It's all right. You want to try?
You got first bite.
You know, living in a basement apartment, you see a lot of these.
That's right. Oh. This is like eat them to beat them.
All right, I'll try.
As a rule, I don't normally.
I love it.
That I'm not so sure about.
Adventurous bunch here.
That I'm not so sure about, and not because it's just got the word in it.
Oh, there you go.
Okay, so talk me about these tarantulas here. We're going to deep fry them, right?
That's right.
Okay, so tell me what
to
do.
This is turning into my specialty dish. What I want you to do.
So go on, what do I do?
I have to tell you, these have actually been already been prepared. We've singed the hairs off of them.
God.
So what, I put it in here?
That's
in
right.
The batter?
In the batter.
I don't even want to.
And then we're going to put them in hot oil.
So it goes in like that, right?
That's right. Get a lot of that batter on there.
God.
Now, James, the only trick is to make sure the legs are spread out.
Make sure the legs
are spread out nicely.
I mean.
Yeah, right. There you go.
What's so that? In there?
In you go.
In you straight go. In?
Yep. Nice.
Right, and, so how long...
And kids,
here's a question I never thought I'd say. How long do we fry a tarantula for?
We're lucky. It's not like the Thanksgiving turkey, you know, all day. It's okay. Like a minute or a minute
we
and a
so
half.
We are so lucky.
Yeah.
I'm going to say it again. If you're doing this in the audience, make sure there's a grown-up in the room, because hot oil is dangerous.
Yeah, we should also say these bugs have been, you know, taken from a proper place. Don't just go in your garden and go, oh, I can eat bugs, because it really will not end up great.
You might get pesticides, there which would go. Be the worst.
Yeah, that would be okay. That would be so tragic compared to what we're about to do.
There we go. Let's put a little smoked paprika on here, just for color, mostly. And you know, meat is basically muscle, so it's the legs that are the best part. If I rip off a leg for you...
Yeah. Are you going to do a leg?
Ms. Ferris?
Oh, well done, Anna Ferris. Tyler, should you do a leg?
Yeah.
Okay, let's all do a cheers. Ready? Let's all do a toast with a tarantula's
That's
leg.
Right.
All right, cheers. Cheers, Gordon. Cheers.
Cheers.
Down the hatch, here
bon
we go.
Bon appetit.
Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with a hot iron, forbidding to marry and commanding to abstain from meats which God hath created to be received with thanksgiving of them which believe and know the truth. And commanding to abstain from meats which God hath created to be received with thanksgiving of them which believe and know the truth.
The global food shortages, the collapsing supply chains. We warned you about the climate crisis, and now you reap what you have sown. But there is still hope. Thanks again to science, we have a solution. Insects. A sustainable, equitable, and nutritious source of protein for a fraction of the carbon footprint of livestock. We can finally put an end to the wasteful and cruel practice of meat eating for good. So let's turn this crisis into an opportunity to bring equality to our food systems, to mandate social and cultural change. Be a net zero hero. Eat the bugs.
Cut. Fear is the path to the dark side. The fear of change, of progress. Luke, to defeat the Sith, eat the bugs, you must.
Not this time, meat eaters! Insectus consumers!
Avengers! Eat the bugs.
And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, Tell us, when shall these things be, and what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world? And Jesus answered and said unto them, Take heed that no man deceive you, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in divers places. All these are the beginning of sorrows.